Welcome to Emotional Mojo. We're going to solve one of your problems, okay?
That was a very cute expression you just gave. What was that?
Like
what
was that? Yeah,
it was like a little mouse.
I don't know.
It wasn't bad.
Just
it was
happy to be here, I guess.
It was very cute. It was like, hmm.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome. Sorry,
Patrick's
go ahead.
Patrick's going to help us solve this problem, by the way. Our fan, Jean T, she wrote on our website after seeing our segment about how to deal with emotional vampires in your life. She said, I think my husband of many years and I are both emotional vampires to each other at times. We're not going to pull back from each other, so I guess the hard task here is to learn not to be one. Any suggestions for that? Now, Patrick, before we jump into that, let's revisit really quickly what an emotional vampire is, and then we'll get to their specific.
An emotional vampire is anyone in your life that literally, well, not literally, sorry.
I would hope not.
Yeah, hope not.
Literally, that sucks the life right out of you, drains your energy. Whenever you're around them, you feel bad about yourself, you feel drained, you feel weak, you feel helpless, you start to doubt yourself.
So and anyone typically, that's, we're anyone worried that's dragging about you down. The people doing that to us, but this person's saying, I realize that's me and that's my husband, we do it to each other. So if you're the vampire, what do you do?
Well, before I give you that solution, let me also just list out very quickly the five vampires.
Okay.
There's a narcissist who only focuses and is only interested in him or herself. There's the controller who says, hey, you don't know what you're doing, I have to control your life. There's a criticizer always telling you what's wrong with you, that you're wrong, you're bad, and you're doing wrong things. Mm-hmm. Then there's also the victim that says, oh, I'm poor, poor, pitiful me. And then finally, there's the drama queen that always creates a scene. So in this case...
Well, I have a question, Patrick. Does she need to know which one she is in order to address
that's
it?
That's what I was leading up to. I'm curious myself when she says, look, I'm an emotional vampire, my husband's an emotional vampire.
Right.
They read the article online at emotionalmojo.com. And I'm sure they can find out which one they are. But okay, so here's the question. How do you conquer this mental emergency? So the solution is, what if you're the emotional vampire, what do you do? Number one, you've already identified you're the emotional vampire. Step back and separate yourself from the behavior. So what you do, you stop beating yourself up. Don't say, oh, I'm so bad, I'm an emotional vampire. You're already probably engaging in self-loathing. Step outside, look at the behavior, and start using the word, that behavior.
Okay. So
instead of
my behavior. Because whenever you use the word my, it means
possession.
I own it.
Yeah.
And even in Buddhist teachings, they talk about separating yourself.
Yeah.
So this is mindfulness, separating yourself from the behavior and then becoming an observer.
Well, and I'm wondering too, she says we've been married for many years.
I'm
wondering if when you're in a relationship for so long, especially a marriage, if you find yourself in these patterns
maybe
she's not an emotional vampire in other relationships, but with her husband, she tends to be that
vampire.
That's
a great point, Tara. Yeah. That's very insightful because what you're saying is they've created this pattern, they've created this habit, and only now they're probably waking up to it. So you've got to be specific. I would say sit down and write and ask yourself, what am I actually doing that makes me an emotional vampire? And last but not least, stop and ask yourself, what do I want when I'm engaging in this behavior?
Yeah.
What
why am I
feeling?
Down?
When
why
you get
am
to
I
the
there
why,
is a payoff.
Yes, there's a benefit, a payoff.
Because she wrote in, payoff. So obviously she wants to solve it.
So ask yourself, why am I doing this? What benefit do I get? Maybe I want attention. Maybe it's the only way I feel that I can connect. Maybe I'm afraid of intimacy. Start asking yourself those questions and you'll come up with the answer.
All right, and share it with us. Obviously, we want to work you guys into the show and answer some of your questions. So there you go. There's our Facebook page and our Twitter and YouTube. So get there and interact with us.